Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss a new topic called NLTK, which are helpful to design a game in Python Tkinter framework. This is my fourth lecture in game development tutorials. If you didn't watch previous lectures, please pause the video and go and watch the previous tutorials. The tutorial link is provided in the below description. Now, let's come back to the tutorial. This is the small game or any program I designed to explain what is NLTK and why we are using NLTK. NLTK is nothing but natural language processing. It's a natural language toolkit. It's mainly used for in text classification or machine learning, artificial intelligence, these kind of, for designing these kind of algorithms, we mainly use for NLTK. So NLTK is mainly used in pre-processing step of for designing any kind of algorithms. Suppose we have a huge amount of data, which contains more than 1 MB. In that, we have some unwanted words like A and the. Before that, we want to classify the document whether it belongs to a sports or whether it belongs to a film. So by using NLTK, we can easily classify. And NLTK has a huge number of functions. We can simply import them and we can classify the text. In this program, we are taking a matrix. The matrix contains some alphabets, and we want to find the all possible English words in the given matrix we have length greater than 3. For example, we have some dark, break, chocolate. These kind of things are the English words. NLTK has advantage of have some huge amount of English words in predefinedly. So first we need to convert into the character array, and then we pass it on to the NLTK toolkit. It's automatically processed and gives the output. So how can we use the NLTK in Python? We have a library called NLTK. We simply import in our program, and then for English words, we have some separate library called NLTK.corpus. By using NLTK.corpus, we can import the words, all English words. It contains more than 200,000 English words in the particular library. If you are first performing NLTK in your IDE, you need to download NLTK words in your workspace. So finally, learning outcomes. In this tutorial, you learn some bit about NLTK word processing. So let's understanding with example in IDE. Here is the code. I'm using PyCharm as my IDE. You can use any of your own IDE. It's completely up to you. But the logic is same. Hence, here you can import the NLTK toolkit, and for words, for English, for all kind of English words, we just import the NLTK.corpus, and that we have some library called words. We need to import these two functions. And finally, for timing, I take directly a character array instead of taking matrix and converting into character array. For the first time you're running this program, please perform this NLTK.download words. This is helpful to download the complete words into your workspace. For testing, they just print the total list of words, how many words are there in the particular NLTK.corpus. And finally, by using function, I pass the word list and character array into the possible words function. In the counter is helpful to find the length of the particular word, and also it divides every word into the dictionary. A simply counter is nothing but it converts the word into a dictionary format. And we check for every word whether these characters are there in the or not. If yes, we simply print the word which has length more than 5. You can put your own length up. It's completely up to you. Let's run this program. For first time, we need to download the complete NLTK words into our environment, so please wait. Come on. three guys. Total we have ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, tens, hundreds, lakhs. Total we have 2,36,736 words, 736 English words in the particular analytical corpus. In that, we perform some small word processing technique to find the all English words with the contents of character array, and H E L O N V T. And finally, if E is there, it will be more than 4, then print 11, 11th, 11. And these are the total number of characters, total number of words we find by using NLTK. And this technique we use for next program to design a game, like scrambling words. That's it for today's lesson. Thank you friends for watching this video. If you like the video, please subscribe and thumbs up. Okay, bye. I'll see you in the next tutorial. Thank you friends for watching this video. If you like the video, please subscribe and thumbs up. Okay, bye. I'll see you in the next tutorial.